नमस्कार। टुडे विल स्टडी इन्वेंट्री मैनेजमेंट। देर आर फोर एस्पेक्ट्स इन ड्रग स्टोर मैनेजमेंट। फर्स्ट इज सिलेक्शन ऑफ ड्रग्स, सेकेंड इज प्रोक्योरमेंट आफ्टर क्वांटिफिकेशन, देन थर्ड इज स्टोरेज एंड डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन, फाइनली यूज बाय द कस्टमर्स और पेशेंट्स। सो ड्यूरिंग स्टोरेज एंड डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन वी नीड इन्वेंट्री मैनेजमेंट। What is inventory? Inventory is nothing but the stock. So here in drug store management, the stock of drugs is called inventory. Why do we need this inventory? We need this inventory if there is a delay in delivery of drugs or there is an increased demand, then we should have a stock to deal with that. So that is the advantage of inventory, so that we can run the business without any discontinuity. But the disadvantage is we need a lot of space, and that a cost is also involved in maintaining that cost, maintaining that stock. So that may be up to 30% of the value of the drugstore. That means by inventory management we can maintain an appropriate stock level. So how can we do that? We need to determine when to order the products or the drugs, how much to order, how to maintain the stock level. So all these things will be discussed in inventory management. Before that, let us discuss some key terms. Stock on hand is the quantity of usable stock available at any point of time. It does not include the unusable items like your expired items, damaged items. The rate of consumption is the quantity of stock dispensed or sold to the patients. The lead time is the time between the date on which the order is placed and the date on which the order is received and available for use. That is the lead time. Buffer stock is the reserve stock or the safety stock to prevent the stock outs. Review period is the routine interval of time between assessment of stock levels to determine when to place the order. Pipeline is the entire chain of storage facilities and transportation links through which the drugs move from the manufacturer to the consumer. Losses includes the expired products, the theft ones and damaged products. And if in a hospital there are multiple drug stores, and there will be one main store from which the drugs will be supplied to the sub stores. And suppose in one store there is exhaust of drugs, there is no drugs, so it can ask to another store to provide that, and that will be coming under adjustment. In requisition system, the store which is requiring certain drugs, that will write the name of the drug, the quantity of the drug, and that will ask the main store to provide that. And as per requirement, this is given. So this is a pool system, and in pool system, the main store will provide on its own the certain drugs in certain quantity to different sub stores, and that's why it is called pool system. And pool system will give you better results than the push system. Consumption data provide information about the quantity of drugs given or used by the patients, and issue data provides the information about the quantity of goods issued to different departments. Then we will discuss the inventory labels. Different inventory labels are there. Maximum label beyond which the actual stock is not allowed, and that can be calculated as ordering label minus the product of minimum lead time and minimum consumption plus the reorder quantity, or we can use also economic order quantity. Similarly, the minimum level can be calculated as ordering level minus the product of average consumption into average lead time. सेफ्टी स्टॉक कैन बी कैलकुलेटेड इफ वी कंसिडर और अज्यूम द लीड टाइम एंड कंजप्शन ड्यूरिंग लीड टाइम आर कॉन्स्टेंट, देन वी कैन यूज द फॉर्मूला मैक्सिमम कंजप्शन माइनस एवरेज कंजप्शन होल इन टू लीड टाइम, एंड इफ दे आर वेरिएबल देन वी कैन यूज द फॉर्मूला मैक्सिमम कंजप्शन इन टू मैक्सिमम लीड टाइम माइनस एवरेज कंजप्शन इन टू एवरेज लीड टाइम. The ordering label or the reorder label, the label at which a order should be placed can be calculated as maximum consumption into maximum lead time or safety stock plus consumption during lead time, which can be calculated as average consumption per day into lead time in day. The danger label means at any moment there will be stock out. So when the danger label comes, so immediate action should be initiated to get the drugs. And when there is stock out, no drug, then it will be zero label or exhaust bin label. Easily we can set these maximum and minimum labels by following these steps. In first, you have to determine your lead time. Then you have to set the review period, say 1 week or 1 month or 3 months. Then we have to calculate the stock required during this review period. More than half, so 50% to 60% usually, 50% to 60% of the review period stock is usually set as the safety stock. And minimum stock or minimum label will be lead time stock, that is stock required during the lead time plus the safety stock or buffer stock. And maximum stock will be calculated as minimum stock plus review period stock label. Similarly, we can calculate the quantity to order using this formula, monthly consumption adjusted for stock out. So if there is stock out for 5 days in a month, then whatever consumption is there, that we have to calculate for 25 days, so subtracting those 5 days. So for 25 days, this is the consumption, then for 1 day how much, and for 30 days how much. So that will be monthly consumption adjusted. So consumption adjusted whole into your average lead time plus procurement period or review period, then that will be to that we add safety stock and we subtract the combined value of stock in inventory and stock on order. Economic order quantity is the quantity which is most economical to order, and we can calculate it as square root of 2AO by CS. A is annual requirement in units, O is cost of ordering, C is cost per unit, S is storage or inventory carrying cost. Average stock level is the average of maximum level or minimum level. We can also calculate it as the average of maximum level and economic order quantity, or it will be minimum label plus half economic order quantity. Inventory control is the most important function of inventory management, and by inventory control we can know what and how much to stock, similarly what, how much and when to procure, so that the purchasing cost, the storing cost, all will be as low as possible. So the objectives to keep the investment on inventories minimum, to minimize the idle time by avoiding stockouts and shortages, to avoid carrying cost, to improve quality of care. The techniques in inventory control are all these 8 methods are there, and out of them ABC analysis and VED analysis is used mostly for analysis of drug expenditure, and a combination of ABC and VED is also used. In ABC analysis, the consumption value is the basis of analysis. In FS analysis, the consumption pattern or the movement is considered for analysis. In VED analysis, the criticality of the component here, the drug, is considered whether vital or essential or desirable. The unit price is considered in HML analysis, high cost, medium cost, low cost, and problems faced in procurement that is considered in SDE analysis. So ABC stands for always better control is the best method to do the inventory control analysis, and here we calculate the consumption value. Mostly annual consumption value is calculated. Sometimes we can do it half-yearly or quarterly also. And here ABC means as per the consumption value, the highest consumption value are considered A, medium consumption value B, and C will be lowest consumption value. And if you see that highest consumption value is provided by only 5 to 10% of the drugs in the drug store, and the lowest consumption value is provided by 70 to 80% of the drugs, and the medium will be 10 to 20%. So how to calculate this? We have to first calculate the annual consumption value for each item. Then we have to arrange them in the descending order of their annual consumption value. Then decide the cutoff either by based on quantity or based on consumption value. In this example, only 10 drugs are given in this one, and usually in a drugstore there will be more than 300-400 drugs. So you can calculate accordingly, and here we have calculated the consumption value, annual consumption value for each item by multiplying the annual volume in units into unit cost. Then we have calculated the percentage, and we can see the first two items only have the consumption value of 72%, last five items only 5%, and middle three have consumption value of 23%. So if you take a lot of drugs, we will find a figure like this, in which you can see less than 10% of drugs are there coming under group A, but their cost is 70%, more than 70%. And more than 70% of drugs are there in group C with cost only 9%. So from this ABC analysis, we can categorize the A group of drugs which need very strict control, and B items moderate control, C items low control, and accordingly safety stock label, because they are of high cost, group A drugs should have very low or practically nil safety stock, whereas since group C drugs have a very low price, we can have a high safety stock label. Then the control, the consumption control and flow should be daily or weekly for the group A items because of their high cost, and the group B items we can do it in 15 days or 1 month, and with at the 3 months or quarterly we can do it. The consumption control can be done for group C items. Similarly, in VED analysis, according to criticality in patient care, we can classify them as vital, essential, and desirable. Vital means there is no substitute available, and essential means we can have an alternative medicine, we can have the substitutes, and desirable means if the drug is not available also, no problem, and mostly these are drugs used for chronic diseases or less serious patients. So like ABC analysis, we can also do the VED analysis. We can have one ABC VED matrix analysis where we can combine ABC and VED, and accordingly we can have 9 group of drugs: A, V, A, E, A, D, B, V, B, E, B, D, C, V, C, E, C, D. And we can categorize as category 1, category 2, category 3. A, B, A, E, A, D can be categorized as category 1, and category 2 and category 3 accordingly we can prepare. And this category 1 needs close monitoring and control. and highest control is needed for AB group of drugs. So coming under both group A as well as group B. And here one example is there where this ABCD matrix analysis is done. In HML analysis, we consider the unit price based on the unit price, the cost per unit drug, we can have this analysis. So we can classify them as high, medium and low price. So those drugs with high unit cost, they can be given to a senior level executive to sign the requisition forms, and for other drugs we can ask the lower level people to do that. And the tight security can be there for H items and M items also. So we can have a control over purchases. Those drugs with high cost, they should be controlled. In SD analysis, A stands for scarce, D for difficult, E for easy. Scarce, not easily available, very short supply, mostly procured through government machineries and agencies. And for scarce group of items, we should procure only once in a year, so that there will be no problem during that year. And difficult means those items which are not easily available, and mostly if it is monopoly or oligopoly, few manufacturers or suppliers are there. So in that case, the supplier or manufacturers must be informed well in advance, and we can manage that. And easy, all these items are readily available in local market, so there is no problem. So this SD classification helps the purchase department to decide the purchasing method to facilitate the management. In FSN analysis, that is fast moving, slow moving and non moving, so this analysis is based on the movement and consumption of the items. If the drugs are fast moving, that means we should have a strict supervision on reorder level. And if it is slow moving, then we should follow FIFO, fast in, fast out. That means the drugs which are purchased fast should be sold fast, otherwise it will be expired. And non-moving items, if you will analyze, then we can know the dead stock, that they are not moving, so resulting in dead stock and expiry. And we can further classify them as dead stock for 2 years, dead stock for 3 years, dead stock for 5 years, and accordingly we can plan for procurement of these drugs in future. In gulf analysis, the source of supply is considered for analysis, and if the source is government, G, O for ordinary non-government, L for local and F for foreign if the source of supply is outside the country. SOS analysis based on season, off-season, we can have this analysis, and it helps to decide the purchasing strategy. In XYZ analysis, the inventory investment is considered for analysis. So high inventory values are X items, low inventory values are Z items, and inventory value falling between X and Z are Y items. The valuation of inventory we can do by using all these 8 methods. So first is your first in, first out method. In this case, the material which is received first are issued first. Last in, first out, the materials which are received last are issued first. And highest in, first out, the materials with highest price are issued first. And next in, first out, the materials which are ordered but not yet received, that price is considered while selling. So next in, first out. So we can see this problem on fast in fast out method. In this case, on April 1, 200 units purchased at 50 per unit, and on April 5, 500 units purchased at the cost per unit is 60, and on April 10, 300 units sold. So when we sell 300 units, we have now 700 units. So out of this, first we have to sell the lot which are purchased on April 1. So 200 units and rest 100 units we have to take it from April 5. So the value of stock sold will be 200 units on from April 1, 100 units from April 5. So remaining unit is your 400 units that is purchased on April 5. So the closing stock, when we calculate the closing stock, we have to consider that 400 units from the stock of April 5. So the closing stock will be 400 into 60, 24,000. And whereas the value of stock sold will be 200 units from April 1 and 100 units from April 5. So total 10,000 plus 6,000, 16,000. In the same way, in LIFO method, the last in first out, that means on April 5, the drugs which are purchased will be considered first, then on April 1 will be considered. So accordingly, we can have the calculation for the value of stock sold and the closing stock. In the average cost method, if the goods have been mixed up in such a manner that it is difficult to identify each lot separately, then in that case, we can use this average cost method. Simple average method, we can add the price and divide it by 2, but we should use the weighted average cost. So 1000 units into rupees 3, 3000 rupees, 5000 units into rupees 5, 25,000 rupees. So total is 28,000. So weighted average cost will be 28,000 divided by the total number, that is 5000 plus 1000, 6000. So it will be rupees 4.67. There is another method called market price method or realizable price method or replacement price method, in which the issue is priced at the market price prevailing on the date of issue, and it includes the acquisition cost, inverse price and transport charges. In standard price method, a planned and scheduled price is used, and the actual acquisition cost is considered. Inflated price method is used for those goods which are subject to some wastage. We can see one example. 100 packets of menthol are purchased at the rate of rupees 60 per packet, and there is wastage of 10% menthol during its storage. So in this case, because of 10% wastage, we'll have now we have to calculate now for 90 packets instead of 100 packets. So the total cost is 100 into 66,000. Now cost per packet, we will calculate it for 90 packets instead of 100 packets. So 6000 by 90, it will be rupees 66.66. So this is all about inventory management. Thank you.